Good morning, everybody. Welcome to our new live stream. We are in a beautiful sea of flowers. It's almost getting an ocean of flowers. We have collected over 100 tulip varieties. You see narcissus, hyacinths, and also beautiful amaryllis. We are promoting. Welcome back to our show. In this difficult time, still the corona situation is terrible. Still every day we see news in our on the radio, in the TV, in the newspapers about the vaccine, about questions being made about transport. So yeah, the situation is still difficult. Let me introduce also to Katja and Nico.
Welcome everybody.
Доброе утро всем. Добро пожаловать на наше онлайн цветочное шоу. Мы будем рады вам показать в сегодняшнем выпуске амариллисы, много сортов, более 100 сортов тюльпанов, гиацинты, нарциссы. Оставайтесь с нами, делитесь этим эфиром, будет интересно. Nico?
You see the amaryllis, you see the spider types and the butterfly types. These we have collected from our growers. They are popular varieties. The spiders are very unique and very special. It is a little bit a small market, but it's interesting. Arctic nymph, that's one of the nymph series, next to nymph. That is the double series. Beautiful amaryllis, and with a big demand from many countries, a big popularity. They're getting more and more popular and a bigger share of the market. Although they are still quite limited in availability. They are not always easy to grow for the bulb grower. And they are still new. And also with amaryllis, it takes many years to develop. Pretty nymph, with a beautiful bicolor pink variety. Also very nice. And popular in many countries.
Мы сейчас хотим представить вам несколько сортов амариллисов из нашего ассортимента. Амариллисы с каждым годом набирают свою популярность. Мы также занимаемся продажей этих луковиц. Полный ассортимент вы можете посмотреть на нашем сайте. Мы занимаемся поставками луковиц для профессиональных цветоводов и импортеров. Поэтому, если вас интересуют эти луковицы, вы можете просмотреть наш ассортимент и связаться с нами по электронной почте.
Sunny nymph, it's beautiful, very bright color. That's also on the poster behind. The beautiful painting. And the amaryllis is very suitable for the warm climate, for warm countries. It has a very long flowering time. It is very strong. Here you see them as cut flowers, but mostly they are used for the pot plants in the foreign markets. And then in many countries we get a very nice demand and a great interest of the amaryllis. Each country has its different taste for the color, but yeah, as using as a pot plant, it has a very big advantages. And especially in the warm climate, flowering from December even until Mother's Day, until May, you can have a long flowering period.
Какой плюс этих луковиц? У амариллисов очень долгая продолжительная жизнь в вазе, и в Голландии этот цветок очень популярный на Рождество. Плюс в том, что вы можете получить долгое цветение, начиная от декабря и до Дня Матери в мае.
This is White Amadeus. That is a new white variety. Also with a beautiful double flowers. And there are varieties, the growing characteristics is also very important, of course, both for the bulb grower and for the consumer, for the results in their pots. And then, therefore, we always have to select the varieties which are also in the good bulb quality. Here you see Pretty Nymph. Also a super soft pink color, and next to it is Rebecca. That's a small type flowering.
also a lot of demand from Mexico for amaryllis. Yeah. So yeah. Please join our YouTube channel for if you want to join more our videos with amaryllis.
And now we move on to the tulips.
We have this week we have a lot of varieties. I don't know how much exactly, but it's enormous. A lot of new varieties, promising varieties. Not for all is a lot big availability, but yeah, we try to explain all the sorts. We put it a little bit on the color, so you can follow us by color.
А теперь мы переходим к тюльпанам. У нас появилось очень много сортов тюльпанов. Мы не знаем, успеем ли мы показать все сорта, поэтому мы их расставили по цветам. И если у вас будут вопросы, пишите нам в комментариях, мы постараемся ответить во время этого или во время следующего эфира. Поэтому будьте с нами, задавайте вопросы, все ваши комментарии, пожелания, они только приветствуются.
One of the new sorts, new purple ones, is Ruska. It's an early one. It only needs 11 cooling weeks, so you can flower it already with Christmas. Next to it, you see Barracuda. Very nice 5 degrees tulip. Very nice color in the during the forcing in the bud, and also very suitable for water forcing. Piton is a new double purple one. Bullet, also a nice new promising from week one flowering.
Мы показали вам сорта, новые сорта. Это Рюшка, он только появляется на рынке. Показали вам Bullet, это наш эксклюзивный сорт. Сорт Piton. Пеновидный сорт темно-фиолетового цвета. И хотим обратить также ваше внимание на сорт Bullet. У Bullet'а, Bullet это очень хороший сорт. Он легко выгоняется на гидропонике и на грунте. Аккуратный лист и очень хороший выход.
Camellia, this is a very beautiful new bicolor tulip with a clear white edge. Can be very suitable for Japan. It's a little bit of color similar like Merry Widow. It's maybe a little bit more purplish, but it's beautiful variety, nice type.
Мы хотим представить вам сорт Камалия. Камалия это очень новый сорт. У него необычная расцветка с ярко выраженной белой каймой. Рядом возле него стоит сорт Ацент, также необычный. Тоже аккуратный лист и хорошая высота.
Now you see some oldies, mutations from Monte Carlo, Viking. You see Monte Orange, it's doing well. The double is quite popular all over the world in the moment. And everybody's looking for good forcing sorts for double ones.
We also have a first question. If it's possible, if you see a sorted, that needs to open, can there be a sort of opnomen also? If sort of lifelong stand in the knob?
In the butt,
in the knob, yeah.
Okay, here you see the first.
If we're talking about the doubles, if I may say, like on the flower, like Nico said, they are very popular in many countries, both in Asia, in Japan, and also in Russia, in Europe, on the flower auction, the flower prices are very high. Actually, they are almost sky high, historically high. So in this dark period of Corona, the tulip flowers are doing very well. The average price of the doubles was this was the day before yesterday was 27 euro cents per stem. And for the single ones, it was 20 euro cents per stem.
Сейчас мы хотим ваше внимание обратить на сорт Pontiac. Это новый хороший фиолетовый сорт.
You see Pontiac, new purple double one. These are the first which are flowering, so it's week four now. So I think it's a promising, nice blue color, purple color. Now you see some new ones, Avillon, Montezuma, also quite new purple ones.
You see a wide range of only purple varieties, already 15, I think, both single and double. And yeah, like we always say, it's not so easy, not so difficult to introduce new varieties, but it's very difficult to introduce good new varieties. Here you see Laptop, that is a very popular variety nowadays in Holland, moving close to Purple Prince and following Purple Prince and Purple Flag. It's a very good variety. Margarita, that's one of the main double varieties in the acreage, in the production, and in the popularity. Margarita was the highest price of 27 euro cents on the flower auction.
Мы представили вам несколько новых и уже известных вам фиолетовых сортов по поводу цены на цветочном аукционе в Голландии. Маргарита, последняя цена на Маргариту была
27 euro cents.
27 евро центов, Маргарита.
And 27,000 stems.
27,000 было продано последний день сорта Маргарита на рынке.
There are also a lot of mutations from Margarita. Just you saw Kite Man, that is an orange one. It's coming from Margarita. You have Margarita, you have Ippon, and you have yellow Margarita, and that are all mutations, and they are very suitable for the water forcing. Here you see Respectable, that's quite similar to Pontiac, and it's the first test in our greenhouse, and I was surprised how good it was looking. Omar Pavlovich, also an early one. Will Bow, a double one. Here you see Gabriela, a light pink one.
Сейчас мы показываем сорт Gabriela, нежно-розовый цвет. We also have questions: why not a lot of varieties from Narcissus varieties you can find on website Jan David & Zonen? So many varieties that you show last live stream, not yet on.
That's right. We have also many varieties on our website, I think, but there's always some movement in newer varieties or in different varieties. And the varieties we show you here that are popular varieties for the cut flower forcing and for early forcing. So it's depending a little bit on the demand and on the market and on the year what varieties we can have in our offer. And that's the same with the tulip. We have many tulip varieties in our offer. And like Nico just explained about Respectable and what we show here, not all the varieties are available yet, but we are working on the production and we are working on the availability with our growers.
К нам поступил вопрос, почему не все сорта нарциссов находятся на нашем сайте, но представлены на выставке. Это потому, что мы выставляем на сайт только то, что доступно. То есть, если этого сорта еще нету в продаже, или это достаточно новый сорт, возможно, его еще не будет на нашем сайте. Other remark from Julia. Can you also explain, if you show a variety, can you also explain of its early variety, of its middle variety, of its late variety?
Now we just show you Cabana. That's a parrot type, that's a sport of first class. That's a rather early variety, that's one of the earliest parrot types, I think. Together with Parrot Prince, for example.
You see Argos, an early pink-purple one, very popular in Russia.
Здесь мы показывали вам сорт Argos, который имеет необычную светло-фиолетовую расцветку и очень популярный в России, в Беларуси. У него хорошая высота и большой бутон. The bloom schnell open by Argos. Бутон у Аргоса быстро не открывается.
Now you see Tompous. Now you see Tompous, a mutation of Dynasty. Very nice pink color. Then you get a mutation of Verona. You have Verona, Verona Sunrise, Mary Jo, Scarlet Verona.
Good the forcing variety.
Yeah, absolutely, and good on the water forcing. Now you see Memphis. I think that's also a very strong variety, not early, middle late, but a very nice pink color, suitable for water, suitable for 5 degrees, strong, long tulip, and nice leaves.
Мы показали вам Мемфис, который подходит для выгонки на грунте или на гидропонике. И сейчас мы показываем вам сорт Ульяна.
Now you see, I think Sirene, is that right?
Yeah, Sirene.
Sirene. Yeah.
К вашему вниманию мы хотим представить сорт Sirene. Это отличный сорт. Некоторые могут взять его как замену для династии. У него аккуратный лист, большой бутон, очень хороший выход. То есть,
yeah, nice upstanding leaves, strong plant. It starts white, the color in the bouton. And later it becomes more pink. And this variety is also available. That's also an important point.
We have a question for Nico. Why Memphis sometimes have two buds?
I think that's because it's a, but I'm not sure. I think it's about, it's a new lot and they are, in the nursery, they plant every time the big bulbs. I think when it's a normal planting.
Почему поступил вопрос, почему у Мемфиса двуголовые выходят? Это в зависимости от питомника. Если питомник, то есть место, где выращивают луковицу в Голландии, высаживает слишком большую луковицу, использует как посадочный материал на поле, то мы думаем, что это может из-за этого. We also have a next remark. If it possible, show Anna Krasavica tulip.
Yeah, but that's not flowering yet by us. Here you have seen the Sunrise Dynasty mutation of Dynasty. Double twist and new double one. Pink red in the bud. And later on it's more red in the bud.
White shark, a white fringed variety. It's not easy to find good white fringed variety suitable for forcing and in the good quality. Many varieties are weak for fusarium, and also the white varieties are always weak for the virus.
Pink stone, new pink one. It looks like the old Blenda colors, and as also one of the colors we are looking for. I think it's a promising, it looks promising, that's for sure. Next to it is the normal Dynasty. Also, you know the sort and you know the mutations. Florence, it's the same crossing as Pink Stone. It's quite similar.
Мы показали вам новые сорта в нашем ассортименте. Это Pink Stone, Florence, Milkshake сейчас показываем, Династия. То есть это сорта бело-розовые, на которые очень много спроса и популярность каждым год к ним только растет.
Here we see First Class. Quite a big sort in the nurseries. The flower is not the biggest, but it's very early, and that's one of our the advantages. And we have a lot of mutations also from First Class. It's Polar Bear, it's the white one, it's Joella, it's more pink one, and we have... which one I'm missing? No, I forget someone, but we will come on later to it. Trésor, nice purple one.
Дай pink one.
Pink one.
Мы хотели бы также обратить ваше внимание на Трессор. Это сорт, у которого большая перспектива, большой розовый бутон, нежный цвет, аккуратный лист. Кашарель рядом находится, которую все любят. И сорт Crown of Dynasty.
Yeah, that's like a crown flowering type.
What is the size of what of Crown of Dynasty?
Now that's one of that's a small disadvantage that the flower bud is rather small. It's a little bit smaller than the normal dynasty. But it's a very special, unique shape. And it's very good for the and it's a good forcing variety. So that's also very important, of course, as it is a dynasty.
Мы представили вам сорт Crown of Dynasty. У Crown of Dynasty небольшой бутон. Но это очень необычный сорт, необычная форма бокала. Сейчас мы представляем вам сорт First Price. Can you explain about First Price?
It's an early one. It's a mutation from Double Price. You have First Price, Double Price, and now they made a lot of crossings with it. I believe, I'm not 100% sure that, but respectable, and I think also Pontiac are crossings with this kind of types. And this, all over the world, but it's a quite popular tulip that is Flashpoint. It's a mutation from Viking. The nice white edge on the leaves is very nice, and especially in the bud, it looks very attractive.
Здесь находится сорт Flashpoint. Сорт Flashpoint — это мутант от сорта Викинга. Некоторые спрашивают, есть ли сорта, у которых будет двухцветный лист. То есть у него белая окантовочка, всем известный хороший сорт.
Corolla. Also a nice pink one.
Ohayou gozaimasu, Japan. Domo arigato. Welcome to join us. Ni hao, China, I see.
Next question from YouTube. Do you have on your exhibition variety Shirley Double? And what do you think about Shirley Double enforcing?
Shirley Double is not... It's not able to force. It's not possible.
Shirley Double не представлен на нашей выставке, поскольку мы этот сорт не рекомендуем для выгонки. Он не хороший для выгонки. And why it's not good? It's not possible of.
It's not possible to force. It's not.
Его невозможно выгонять этот сорт. Сорт Shirley Double.
Here you see Pink Flag, one of the mutations from Purple Flag. You see Joella, that's also a mutation of First Class.
We also have a question from Tony Tang. Which variety is suitable for Chinese New Year?
Yeah, many of these varieties are suitable for Chinese New Year. But for China, another point is that, like we showed Milkshake, like Dynasty, World's Favorite, it's important that the variety is suitable for export to China, so that it meets the virus conditions. Here you see Orange Ninja, Ninja, that are also suitable for Chinese New Year. But there are only a limited range of varieties which are tested for Arabis mosaic virus and which can be used actually for export to China. And besides, also the bulbs must be in good condition, they must be clean. So they should not be weak for Fusarium. So they are very high quality standards for China. Time out.
Time out, one of the most, I think most promising orange tulips. Yeah. Good in the bud, nice in the bud. You see, maybe I can show our camera man. You see the bud is only in the top, it's a little bit orange. And the bud is still green, orange. So this is very nice to
for the selling stage.
Yeah, and for the transport.
Time out — это очень перспективный сорт. Нико вам показал, как окрашивается бутон. У него аккуратный лист, хорошая высота. То есть бутон сразу в начале окраски показывает свой цвет.
Yeah, now we are to world's favorite.
Yeah, so that is Nihao, that is the number one variety for China. But it's also popular for some customers in Russia. It's a very good 5 degrees tulip. And it's, the flower becomes very big. It's a Darwin hybrid, but it's still a very popular variety in several countries. But especially in China, it's the number one.
We also have a question. We grow purple flag, and it's rather short. Can you recommend me a taller purple variety?
Yeah, laptop, bullet, Alma Pavlovich,
Barracuda.
Barracuda, purple eye. Yeah, there are coming a lot of purple new promising tulips. Now we coming to the red with a white edge.
Yeah, the Japanese flag, very popular varieties in Japan. Like world's favorite for China with the red yellow is red white, popular in Japan, but also in Poland, also in many other countries, and also in Holland red white is popular. And here is the Universum. That is a very good variety, a new one. Nico?
For early forcing. Universum, I think you can already the end of the year or a week one.
Are the kind of tulips be grown in the Philippines? Question. If it's possible to force tulips in the Philippines with the weather?
That's very difficult and very, very warm and very high humidity. So I think it's very difficult to force tulips in the Philippines.
And for landscaping?
It's too hot. Basically, the climate is too hot for the tulips. For your country, the amaryllis is very good, and also lilies can be suitable.
You saw Timeless, you saw Dutch Design. Also very nice, 5 degrees, 9 degrees, on the water, on the soil. Yeah, you can use it everywhere, Dutch Design.
Marrero is our exclusive variety. Обратите внимание на сорт Marrero, это наш эксклюзивный сорт.
And the colors are changing a little bit in the Marrero. It starts a little bit white pink, but later on it becomes more white dark pink.
У Marrero есть небольшой секрет. Он набирает цвет во время окрашивания бутонов. То есть чем больше бутон подрастает, тем больше он становится ярче. Если у вас есть вопросы или комментарии, пожалуйста, пишите нам.
Concorde is one of a new sort with crossings with double price, and now we are week four. These were the first who are flowering. Yeah, you see Columbus. That's a quite big variety at the moment, and also very nice on the bud, my opinion. Very nice double on the bud.
Columbus is the only double variety in the top 20 of biggest acreage varieties. Last year the acreage was 145 hectares. And it's introduced in the year 2006. Katja?
Columbus – это сорт, который начали выращивать в производственных целях в 2006 году. И с каждым годом он набирает свою популярность. И сейчас его продают большое количество этого сорта на срез. And maybe you also can check what is the price for Columbus.
That I wanted to tell you exactly, so we have the same thinking. Yesterday it was 30 cents at a flower auction.
Вчера Columbus был продан на аукционе, средняя цена была 30 центов. Это для товарищей из группы Выгонка тюльпанов, кто интересовался.
That was the highest price.
Это была самая высокая цена.
The quantity was 110,000 stems.
Количество колумбуса вчера было 110 тысяч. And how about prices in Holland of violin action? Prices are
Yeah, the prices are very high, are historically high.
Цены исторически на тюльпан на аукционе высокие, поэтому это хорошо.
This is very good for growers.
Yes. Yeah, that's very good for the market.
You see also one of our exclusive tulips, Cartago. Good for forcing, week 51, 52 flowering. You see Antarctic Fire, mutation of Antarctica. Red label. We grow them under the plastic, under the foley, to force them in week 48, 49. Very nice, and also it's a very nice color, popular in Japan. And we use it more and more also in Holland and in Russia.
Yeah, and a very good substitute for Ben Verzante, for Christmas flowering especially.
Если мы говорим о ранней выгонке перед Новым годом или Рождеством, мы хотели бы представить вам сорт Red Label. Это наш эксклюзивный сорт. Он подходит для 48-49 недели. Мы выращиваем его под пластиком.
And I see a question coming in from Tony Tang about any tulips look like peony. Here you see double twist, for example. This is a very big flower, very double, many petals, that we can almost call like a peony flower.
Nico, we also have a question from Sergei Zelenin. How about situation on the field with tulips? Can you explain more about weather and about fields? How our fields looks like?
The planting time went quite well. November, December went quite well, but in just before Christmas we get a lot of rain, and yeah, it was a little bit worried by some growers. They were worried, and also now in the moment we get a little bit of frost, but after that we get again a lot of rain. So it looks okay, but some growers are well worried about the situation.
К нам поступил вопрос от Сергея Зеленина. Добрый день. Добрый день. Какая обстановка на полях с тюльпанами? Обстановка, в принципе, хорошая. Посадка прошла хорошо. Перед Рождеством в Голландии было очень много осадков. Некоторые производители, они немножко переживали. В принципе, сейчас это все выглядит нормально, но также в последнее время выпали осадки, поэтому мы проверяем, мы работаем, и мы надеемся, что погодные условия будут соответствовать.
You see Royal Dutch, a nice yellow new trumpet narcissus with a good height. And we just showed you Orange Lion as the hyacinth orange one. It's very special.
And if we speak about Red Label on plastic, and last week also we have a question about Roman Empire. Nico, Roman Empire on plastic from Dutch bulbs is possible? When you can get first flowering of Roman Empire from plastic?
It is possible, Roman Empire on the plastic, but it's not available, and it's not available in the moment.
Roman Empire на был вопрос на прошлой неделе. Roman Empire на пластике, под пластиком выращивать возможно или невозможно? То есть когда он зацветет? Это возможно, но он пока недоступен. Нет в наличии его.
You see red stone, new red tulip early. It's a crossing met Mont Peony and Kung Fu. Looks nice, big flower, nice leaves. You see Scarlet Verona, it's also a mutation of Verona. It's a nice double red tulip. And also nice on the water forcing. One of the biggest red sorts, I don't know the acres exact, but is it in the top 20, Strong Love, Jan?
Yes, yeah. Yes, it's in the top 20.
And now you see also, this is a red light. It's a very, I showed the first one last week. It's a very nice red color. It's exclusive from us. Yeah, it's very nice on the 5 degrees. We're testing also, we grow them also more and more in Russia on the water. Yeah, it looks very nice.
Very it's big flower. You can see it's a bright red color if you compare with Strong Love. It's much darker. So that's a big advantage for red light.
Здесь мы хотим вас познакомить с нашим эксклюзивным сортом Red Light. Мы можем его сравнить с другим сортом Strong Love. Это наш эксклюзивный сорт, который мы очень работаем с ним в России, в Украине. У него большой бутон, аккуратный лист, хорошая высота. Сравните этот сорт. Цвет у него насыщенный, яркий. То есть другие, можно другими словами сказать, чтобы сравнить. Это очень тяжело передать весь оттенок, но вот такой цвет у него пионерского галстука. Поэтому вот сравните, посмотрите по высоте и размер бутона. Очень рекомендуем. And we also have a question. Can you show Columbus again? No, we don't show Columbus again, but if you want private tour, you can always call and contact us and we make for you personal video exhibition via WhatsApp. Есть, можно ли еще раз показать ваши колумбусы? Нет, у нас очень мало времени, мы хотим показать другие сорта. Если вы заинтересованы в этом, мы вам можем сделать персональную экскурсию по цветочному шоу Ян Давид. Наберите нас в Вайбере или WhatsApp, телефон указан на сайте, в русскоязычной версии сайта.
Now we see a very strong new red-yellow tulip. It's a Tarzan. It's a crossing of Hunter and an tetraploid. Tetraploid, and yeah, it's very nice, nice and long tulip.
And it's available. So please send your orders and your inquiries.
Это отличный сорт Тарзан. Обратите внимание, те, которые ищут. Тюльпаны-гиганты. На прошлом лайвстриме был такой вопрос. Хотят вы получить тюльпан с большим бутоном, большой высоты? Этот сорт для вас.
We see good old Lane van der Mark. Already standing, I think, more than 2 weeks here. And here you see China Girl. We see it later on, what was mentioned for the exhibition, but we showed it here. It is our exhibition, but here you see China Girl. Yeah, it's a very long vase line and very nice in the butt, very nice red yellow edge, and it shows the yellow edge very nice only in the already in the butt.
Yeah, clear colors, very sharp, nice upstanding leaves.
Сорт China Girl, эксклюзивный сорт, большая высота, подходит для выгонки на 14 февраля, на 8 марта. Аккуратный лист, большой бутон, очень долгая продолжительность жизни в вазе. К нам поступил вопрос, что такое тюльпаны под пластиком. Это тюльпаны, которые выращиваются на полях под пластиком. Таким образом, тюльпан на полях зацветает на 2 недели раньше, и можно добиться с этих луковиц ранней выгонки, например, в декабре.
Rudolf, thank you very much for joining us today. Nice to show you our tulips. Here's the Verandi, one of the favorite ones. That's one of the top 20.
And there are also some promising mutations from Verandi that is rescue. You saw it earlier, and later on we will see replay. And when we talk about a red tulip with yellow edge, two colors, then I think also replay is a very nice, promising tulip. Nice in the bud, nice in the forcing, nice 5 degrees, 9 degrees.
Если мы говорим про двухцветный красно-желтый тюльпан, мы также хотели бы вам рассказать о сорте replay. Сорт replay это мутант сорт от сорта Веранди. У него такие же хорошие характеристики. 100 луковиц посадили, 100 цветов собрали. Очень удобно с ним работать. На машинах, вручную, аккуратный лист, хороший бутон.
Here you see Hyacinth Jan Bosch. That's one of the most popular ones in China. It's a red color. Also a very old variety, maybe 100 years old already. But it's still going strong.
Работаете только с крупными покупателями или с мелкими тоже? Ну, мы работаем с... У нас есть разные клиенты. У нас есть большие клиенты, небольшие клиенты. Вы всегда можете отправить нам письмо на электронную почту, сообщить, какие сорта, в каком количестве вы выращиваете, и мы с удовольствием вам ответим.
And about going strong. Kijk, here we have strong gold in the earlier stage and in the later stage. And you can see how big the flowers become. This is the number one variety in Holland.
Сорт номер один по ареалу в Голландии, самый популярный, один из самых популярных сортов в России, в Украине, в Беларуси. Мы показали вам Strong Gold в двух стадиях. Первая ваза – это Strong Gold, который зацвел 20 января, и второй уже более, когда нам набрал расцветку, это 1-го, то есть между 1 января. Между ними 20 дней разницы, обратите внимание. 20 дней разницы.
It's rather cool here, maybe around 15 degrees, but it's flowering already for one month. It's unbelievable. From January 1st.
С 1 января он у нас стоит в зале. Здесь немножко прохладно, возможно, где-то 14 градусов, но целый месяц он стоит у нас в вазе. Это качество. This is quality.
Yeah, this is quality. It's about 1,200 hectares. It's almost 10% of the total bulb production. The number two variety is just over 500 hectare, so with a far distance it has the biggest production, and also the flower price was still very good. Yesterday the flower price of the top quality strong gold from Heemskerk was 33 cents.
Вчера цена на strong gold хорошего качества с Heemskerk региона Голландии была 33 цента. К нам также поступал вопрос от Саши Бурмантова, но мы его не можем увидеть. Пожалуйста, напишите ваш вопрос еще раз.
And the average price was 20 euro cents.
И средняя цена на Strong Gold вчера была 20 центов.
And the total quantity was 420,000.
Вчера было продано 420 тысяч Strong Gold на голландском аукционе цветов.
That was also about 10% of the total cut flower sales at the auction.
Это примерно было 10 продажа Strong Gold вчера 410 тысяч. Это примерно 10% от всего проданного среза.
Now, just you saw already the Mary Jo, mutation from Verona. So I don't need to explain more, I think. Then you see Lopke, that's when you don't want to use strong gold, you want something else, or you have problems with the high humidity or something else, you can use Lopke. That's also very nice for the early forcing. And next to it you see Sunbeam, and that's a crossing, this new one is a crossing of Purple Flag and Double Price.
Sunbeam — это новый сорт, это сорт, полученный в результате скрещивания сортов Purple which varieties?
Purple Flag и Double Price.
И новый сорт Лобке. Хотим познакомить вас с этим сортом. Высота 40-45 сантиметров. Сорт, который отлично подходит для выгонки перед Новым годом, Рождеством, на 14 февраля, 8 марта. Универсальный сорт, с которым легко работать. Можно его выгонять на гидропонике, на грунте. И самое главное, что этот сорт не боится топпинга.
You see good old Monsella, and here you see a replay where I was just talking about the two color mutation from Verandi. You see more yellow ads, and you already see it in the bud. Nice on water, nice on 5 degrees. I think this is well the first ones which can flower, so not earlier than the end of January.
We also have a question to Jan. Jan, what is the reason that the bolens are so dure? This is a question from Alexander Burmantov. Now bolen.
The bulbs are expensive.
Why? Why bulbs so expensive? What is the reason?
The bulb price is also influenced by the cut flower price. So if the flower price is very good, then the growers are willing to can pay a higher price for the bulbs. A bulb, a tulip, is very difficult to grow. It takes a lot of effort, it takes a lot of time, and for the good quality bulbs, yeah, the price should be high enough, but it We are focusing on the cost price situation.
Чем связана высокая цена на луковицу? Я вам уже объяснил, но если в кратком, это всегда зависит от цены на тюльпан. Если цена на тюльпан высокая, то, соответственно, производители дешево эту луковицу продавать не хотят.
And the bulk price also depends very much on the variety, of course.
И также это зависит от сорта.
Last week there was a question from the white ones that was a good white for the water forcing, I believe. Is that, yeah?
Yes.
You have snowboard. Antarctica, I think, is also good when you have a nice lot and nice bulbs. Also, Cobla is a nice one. It's not ready flowering. And we have Albatross, but it's already flowering week one, week two.
And about snowboard, it's always a lot of discussion. Snowboard, what is better, water forcing or soil?
I like snowboard much more on the water forcing. On the soil, the rooting is not going so well. I have seen them the last 5 years a lot of times uneven. And they have time enough to root, but still they were uneven. So I think it's a very good, nice water forced tulip.
Также очень много есть дискуссий о сорте сноуборд. На грунте лучше выращивать или на гидропонике? Мнение Ника, лучше выращивать на гидропонике. Также к нам поступает очень много вопросов о хорошем белом сорте. Нико вам назвал эти сорта. Это сорт Кобла, which more good varieties for soil with big bud.
Morita-san, konnichiwa. Domo arigato, watching our tulip live stream. I know you are a lily grower, but thanks for attending us, and we will show the lilies soon again. Domo arigato.
Next question about Verona. Расскажите про Верону, желтеет она или остается сливочной. Мы, к сожалению, нам поступает очень много вопросов, и мы не можем отвечать на все вопросы. Если мы не ответили на все ваши вопросы, пожалуйста, свяжитесь с нами, мы расскажем вам после лайвстрима. The Verona is always Verona bleibt cremy of word hail water.
Verona stays cream.
Verona остается сливочной. And our next question: can you advise a good white variety for water forcing for early weeks before New Year, for example, for December, for January? Good white variety for water forcing.
Then I think Albatross is one of the earliest ones. Antarctica all, but that you have sometimes problems with the bulbs. But I think Albatross is the best. And then for the early forcing, and later on you can use also Royal Virgin. That's not a big flower, but you can use it.
Добрый день, Елена. Благодарим вас за вопрос. Мы рекомендуем вам использовать белый тюльпан Albatross для выгонки на гидропонике. Позже вы можете использовать сорт Royal Virgin, но у него не такой большой бутон Антарктика, но иногда могут быть проблемы с луковицей. And how about Cobla on early forcing?
Yeah, it's not so early.
Кобла для ранней выгонки не подходит. And also we have a lot of feedback about Cobla last week. Cobla is sensitive for light, or not?
I think it's the same sensitivity as strong gold, because it's a crossing of strong gold.
К нам также поступало очень много комментариев о сорте Cobla. Cobla – это сорт, который чувствительный к свету или нет? Ника считает, да, это так же, как и strong gold. То есть, потому что это мутант от strong gold.
You see, now you see some hyacinths, but
with the hyacinths, there's also a special technique for the cut flower hyacinths that to the stem, the bottom is still attached. So that the plant remains in a good condition. Otherwise, all the kind of water is flowing out of the flower and the flower cannot bloom. So this is a special technique of harvesting and preparing, and then you can have a very long vase life. Thank you very much, everybody, for watching us, because at the moment we have more than 50 viewers on Facebook already, I think. So even more, Katja says. Thank you very much for joining us.
And can you show polar bear?
Polar bear.
Yeah. We just passed it earlier. You can see it there. Yeah.
Can you explain again?
Next to it, Jan.
Can you explain again more about polar bear?
polar bear is a mutation from first class.
Polar bear – это сорт мутант от сорта first class. Вот мы его вернули, его сейчас показали. У него хорошая высота. It's good height.
Yeah, and first class is one of the top 20 varieties. It is over 200 hectare. It's a variety of 1999. And it shows that it's a very useful variety for the cut flower grower, for the bulb grower. So polar bear can also become a very big variety.
Polar bear, это также он ареалы его растут с каждым годом, и это очень хороший перспективный сорт для среза.
It's very good for water forcing also.
Это хороший сорт также для выгонки на гидропонике. Do you have limousine on your exhibition?
No, we have no limousine.
Not yet.
Not yet, but we have.
Limousина пока нету на нашей выставке, но он будет.
You see Mondial. Next to it, you see also a crown tulip. Very special flower. It's a new type of tulips, but it's coming more and more popular, and it's also not so big in the flower, but it's really special and it's quite popular also all over the world, I think.
Yeah, but one of the problems of white Liebestar is that the bulb quality, the bulb is very weak for the fusarium. It's not easy to grow, so the availability is very limited.
White Liebestar. Флористы очень любят этот сорт. У этого сорта небольшой бутончик. И если вы видите, в тестовой теплице он у нас вырос 40 сантиметров.
You saw Nordkap. It's an early double white one. Week one flowering without any problem.
Question about Lopke. Lopke better of water forcing or of soil?
We saw last week. I saw them on water and I saw them on soil, and it was good both.
Вопрос о лобке. Лучше садить для гидропоники или на земле? Мы прошлой неделе наблюдали за сортом лобки в нашей тестовой теплице. Отлично и для грунта, и для гидропоники. And about substitute for strongholds. Again, I see a lot of question, Nico. Golden ticket, лобка.
Yeah, golden ticket is the early forcing for week 52, week 1. Lobke is from week 1, week 2. Yeah, and then that's what is available, I think.
Если мы говорим о заменах Stronghold, это сорт лобке для ранних недель выгонки, он отлично подходит. Golden ticket также неплохой сорт, как замена Stronghold.
Yeah, and then you have also Friendship, but that's quite long one, and but it's an early one. You can already they can already flower week 51, week 52, but it's not so.
Narcissus, Sweet Paradise, a pink one, Abba, a double one, Pot Hyacinth.
И еще по желтых сортах для выгонки перед Новым годом есть сорт Friendship. Сейчас мы переходим к гиацинтах.
This is how many hyacinths are sold in Holland as a pot plant. You see the good roots. This is Red Glory. It's a double red variety. Very special.
We have
they are just growing. They are not yet in full bloom. So they become even more beautiful.
Last week we have a question from Tumen. How much weeks of rooting and with which temperature?
Yeah, the best rooting time for the hyacinths is 9 degrees, and the period, the minimum period is between 9 and 11 weeks, depending on the variety.
На прошлой неделе к нам поступал вопрос с Тюмени по поводу гиацинтов. Количество недель охлаждения от 9 до 11 недель, и температура 9 градусов. Это идеально. Nico, we have also a question from Olga Akulichova. Olga, добрый день. What do you mean that Stronghold is a little bit sensitive for light? You speak about cobbler and you say like a Stronghold because it's mutation of Stronghold. Stronghold is sensitive for light?
No, not sensitive for light, sensitive for the high humidity.
But about we speak that cobbler is sensitive for light. And you say it's like a mutation of Stronghold.
Yeah, so it's not so sensitive for the light, my opinion.
Nico имел в виду, мы вернемся к вопросу кобле, то, что кобла чувствительна к свету. Нико сейчас исправил меня. Кобла, она не чувствительна к свету, так же, как и Стронгголд, потому что Стронгголд это отцовский сорт сорта Кобла. White varieties again. And also question about double tulips. Which varieties from double tulips can you advise that staat goed rechtop met de grote
I think most of the tulips are the Verona mutations, Avant-Garde, the double twist is standing right up. I think most of the double tulips, what you can force, are standing right up. It get better and better, I think, in a moment.
Які краще тримають голову при вигонці махрові? Double twist, Avant-Garde, Verona.
Here you see our exhibition forcing and our water forcing. Here we have a demonstration. As we grow these tulips, many of these tulips which we showed you today, we grow in the water forcing in our test greenhouse. Here you see the nice roots, the nice bulb, the sprout is starting. This is Viking. On the label we have mentioned all the details about the stock number, about the treatment, you see the QR code, the variety name, all the details. A complete tracking and tracing in which we try to copy the growing condition at our customers. So that we can give you the good advice and we can also follow the growing condition in your greenhouse. And especially this year with the corona, it's very important as we cannot visit you.
Здесь мы вам показали несколько ящиков из нашей тестовой теплицы, и вы можете увидеть то, что вы их выставили по стадии роста луковиц. Такие же ящики находятся в нашей тестовой теплице. Мы отбираем образцы из отправленных партий нашим клиентам, высаживаем у себя в тестовой теплице, на этикетках для каждого сорта указываем информацию о сорте, неделя отгрузки, охлаждение и отслеживаем эту партию у себя в теплице. Поэтому если в вашем заказе больше чем 5400 луковиц, например, размера 12+, это значит, что мы также отобрали этот образец и посадили у себя в тестовой теплице.
And with the water forcing, one of the very important points is, of course, to keep the water clean. So if you see some coloring of the roots, you have to refresh the water regularly.
Еще один момент, что касается гидропоники. Что главное в гидропонике? Если у вас есть сомнения или вы видите то, что цвет воды меняетесь, пожалуйста, меняйте воду.
Yeah, and one of the problems from the latest year, we don't want to clean so many tulips anymore, but there is too much damage by the bulbs. We see it already in the summer, every spot, and it will get an yeah, the penicillium will come on the spot, and
basically, if it's such a small spot, it has no big effect on the growing condition. It stays at the outside of the bulb. Of course, we prefer to have it perfectly clean, but such bulb can produce a good quality flower.
And I think a lot of growers have to
take care about that.
Yeah.
To improve, maybe.
To improve.
It's not dangerous.
No, it's not dangerous.
A small spot is not dangerous.
This is Paradero. This is a nice new variety.
Также по поводу гидропоники. Нико вам показал луковицу. Если луковица немножко механически повреждена, то появляется небольшая плесень. Это не опасно. То есть если повреждения небольшие, плесени немного, это не опасно. Можно, если вы будете поднимать, например, температуру в теплице, то это подсохнет. If you do temperature, hope that it will grow.
Okay. I think it's almost time. we are spending already 1 hour again together with you in our beautiful tulip show. So, thank you very much for watching us again. You can see we are continuing this, we make it the permanent show, and we are succeeding to collect more and more varieties in the good quality, in the good condition. And thank you very much for attending us. Thanks Nico and Katja for the good explanations together. And if you have other questions, please don't hesitate to contact us. We will try to reply most your questions as much as possible. The social media, the email, the all kinds of channels, the telephoning. So thank you very much.
Dankeschön, tak smuke. Thank you very much.
Спасибо вам, то, что были с нами. Мы сегодня не успели все показать. Если у вас есть вопросы, и вы видите, хотите персональную экскурсию по Viber, WhatsApp, FaceTime, позвоните нам, и мы вам покажем все персонально и расскажем более подробно, что вас интересует. Спасибо большое. Дякуємо и до встречи. До свидания.
До свидания. Thank you. Sayonara.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.